What's good, YouTube? And welcome to the house. Another day, another ghost rare confirmed by Konami. This time it's Firewall Dragon, but this image leaves way more questions than answers to the overall communities because of the confusing leaks earlier. The leak showed OG classic Firewall art, where this shows the altar art kind of in that ghost rare form. So, will this be how they bend the rules, Konami, those smart people? Will this art be in the set as an ultra rare instead, and then the OG art is then the ghost rare, letting them kind of play the game of, oh yeah, we said it wouldn't be anything but ghost, but we're gonna do this art, a brand new release this way, or will they push it back in terms of being off the ban list, since, you know, we've gone from March release to April release on the delay, and then reprint it in something like Battles of Legend for the mass errata, and this be the shot heard that, oh, we are going to unban an errata firewall. We don't know, and that also leaves the question about the DMG uncensored leak. Will that be confirmed? This is really exciting overall, and from that excitement, more and more money is pounding into the set. Look at all these sold pre-sales over on eBay. It is getting ridiculous. 160 to 170 for 5 mini box displays. So do the math for you, calculator man. 160 divided by 5. 5 of these mini boxes is $32 each. This is not your typical March reprint set. Now move to April once again. But with that, it's already a dollar per card at retail. You get 15 cards, not 30, per little mini box. That means that people are spending over $2 a card without knowing any kind of ratio, how easy or hard it's going to be. And I hear a lot of hopefuls in the comment section. Oh yeah, it'll be in every display. It'll be in every single one. Oh yeah, it's gonna be so easy. All I know is when Konami says something like, 5 cards in the set will appear exclusively and rarely as beautiful ghost rares. If Konami says it's gonna be hard to get, it's usually extremely hard to get around the 1 per case. But we'll wait, we'll see ratios, we'll see confirmations later. For now, I just know people are spending a ton of money. And you're a hero if you're doing retail or less right now. Tier Zero keeps trying to restock, sells out like that. It's just going, going, gone every time they do. So any heroes want to step up, and glad to see you vendors finally taking a W after L after L after L on product lately. Feels pretty good to actually see this for the vendors and them get a little bit of a win, but consumers, y'all are going way too crazy. Wait for your shops to get it in. Try to get some OTS packs, some other stuff. This is just absurd to me, the rate it's selling at and how people are actually spending their money so poorly on the set that probably will get an unlimited wave, but that raises the question too. What are these first edition ghost as singles going to be out the gate, and how crazy will the competition get on those? I can't wait to see the ratios and see how crazy that's going to be. Something still excite me as Market Man, even if they're going to terrorize your wallets. Fallen of the Albaz has gone pretty much up in price again. It's almost towards 20. We get release after release of lore with him, another fusion, etc. But Rise of the Duelist most likely will be in the 2021 Megatons, as long as there still is a Megaton. Konami can do anything they want, right? They took away the promos as the product. Next, I seriously doubt it. It's one of their biggest products all year and replaces the release of Collector Tins. So we need Rise of the Duelist reprints pretty horrifically. We should be looking forward towards those August or so, depending on product delays. And with that, you are still on a clock for Fallen of Albaz to be good and played versus its reprint. You're playing a dangerous game if you're doing these buyouts and not selling or making something off of them and making sure you get a bit of your investment back if you are trying to play this most dangerous game. Just a word of advice from an old vendor. Next up, Stardust got its archetype updated in the next core set. I believe it's Majesty Dawn coming up after Lightning Overdrive. That would be our fall set. And with that, we do see some Majestic Star Dragon Ghost buyouts, other buyouts like the 10 version go burr, and 10s have been getting bought out, but even stuff like the Legendary Collection, 5 Ds, super rare, 8 listings, going out of stock, going a bit crazy. People are really buying this stuff out. I don't blame them. It's super exciting to see a protagonist ace monster evolve once again as the cover of a set, and the cards, they're pretty darn good, so I look forward to seeing how this turns out overall. A reminder, tuning is still falling down in price from when it was getting played with Jet Synchron and Halk Fibrex and all that crazy stuff. So the Ultra Rares are still pretty available on market here, around $9, and STBL Ultra, not the least desirable thing to have, and the Ultimate Rares are about where they've been chilling for a second or two, around the 50, up. Oh, they were 54, 58, 59, they might be moving little, and they do shoot up rather quickly. So if you're thinking about buying ulti tunings, use that TCG player link in the description down below, costing you nothing extra to support the channel directly for the cards you'd already be buying, or search around other websites where code WHATSGOOD5 might be applicable to support the channel and get yourself a discount. Definitely seeing these start to run away from the market a little. The Reptile support had other things going kind of crazy on the market, as we showed, and Light Serpent seems to be among the targets. The lowest Unlim Blaze It for 29, and then $5 at first edition. This card reads, if this card is sent from your hand to your graveyard, you can special summon it from your graveyard. This card can't be used as a synchro material. Well, that's still a link material, and you can go other directions with it. It is also a light, fitting with that light and dark theme. I see why people are going after it. Oh, and also no hard once per turn clause. That is kind of important for this card as well. Let's look at Blazing Vortex. I actually haven't been looking too hard at it since its release. It seems like Pot of Prosperity is hanging around about where it was. It was 86, 85 low this time. Underworld Goddess has been fluttering between 24 to 28 from what I can tell. Right now, around the $26 mark, as competition heats up. I still feel like this is the Gizmet Kaku of the set, but rather, it's not going to get suddenly rammed and ruined by a new Master Rule like that. So I do think this one might be a little undervalued, as the rest of the set is just so cash-starved. Armed Dragon hanging around that $8 mark, I like to call it once in a while. S-Force is getting eyed by people as maybe an underestimated, undervalued type, but I'm not seeing it really perform on that level. And the rest of the set, the estimated value pulled is just so freaking bad and so top-heavy. But having one card at least worth over the MSRP of the product is helping this not just crash and burn like Phantom Rage so far, and the Starlight choice is pretty good. Last I saw, the cheapest Trishula was at the 300s, but hey, we have a couple under now, and it was trying to gain traction. Here we see it starting to slip a bit. I do have to wonder, again, the long-term competition from the DT and Ultimate Rare, how that's going to pan out, and then you have that Structure deck coming, which should help hype it a little, and I did not see this falling to 350 this quickly. Pot of Prosperity, I'm seeing it played by a lot of duels, but gosh dang, those top Starlights on release are not what they once were. Zeus, this, instead of 500, they're starting to be 350, and the other Starlights just falling out really harsh, really fast. Dragons of Legend is starting to go up a little for the sealed. I still consider this overall a failed product for its release, but with that, people have noticed, there's still a lot of the sealed around. It's not a bad super long-term hold for sealed, as well as I don't think people are just going to start ripping this open for the singles. Let's start buying the singles. You see buyouts on all sorts of stuff. You have Time Wizard of Tomorrow, the secret rare, going one left at $10 before they're $16. The Cyber / Harpy Lady has done nothing but gone up over time. Last time I think I covered this around $10, being like, oh, that's pretty wild, and now it's even further than that. I would probably suggest getting stuff like the Dark Magician Girl Dragon Knight and other such cards like Tamiya sooner than later. And Numeron Dragon actually has been going a little bit crazy for itself. Number 100 here. The secret rare is getting up in price a bit, and there's very low listings for what this card is on all other versions. So if you're a number collector, that secret rare might be smarter to go ahead and nab now. And even if you're looking for a lower rarity version, this might be one of the last times you see it cheap, as people are making runs on this card, along with anything they think can be bought out from Dragons of Legend. Again, though, with the product still there in vendors' hands, that leaves the chance for the equilibrium to be, okay, it's worth opening these now, I'm gonna open them, make you buy them out again. It's really this back and forth between sealed and singles whenever we're still this young on a product, like in the first year, especially talking a failed product. Remember Pendulum Evolution and how people are, wait, it's finally worth money? Bust it open! And they were trying to sell those pen calls for sixes and all sorts of stuff like that. I remember that. So having just a little bit of money in Pendulum Evolution as a recharge, this could also help people kind of go for opening theirs and going for those kinds of quantities. That being said, hopefully you enjoyed today's Market Watch. I know we have an array of topics to get through besides just what's going on the market. And I'll see you guys tonight on the live stream, 7 o'clock Central. But what do you think of what's going on with stuff like ghosts from the past and these kinds of reveals, leaving a lot of questions along with the quote-unquote answers? And then how people are spending their money versus the race of the Megatons this year. You have a lot of time to still play within there, but versus the cards becoming meta relevant or good, and then I guess how hard it is to get Rise of the Duelist cards. Rise of the Duelist just seems like overall stonks. It's funny how people are starting to target the lower end and it's sticking to the wall most of the time. It's just blowing my mind how much value has been in this one set that got underprinted and then underestimated as well. I remember when we had the misprints, actually. Remember the super common misprints we showed off on the channel? Where, common by the way, where the names were like shifted and half off and they were selling for like barely above the MSRP. You did pretty good for yourself if you held on to those droplet and talents and that kind of stuff early. I saw them selling for 120 because people thought they were so common. Turns out, it wasn't really that easy to get, and they're really freaking cool.